Hello everyone. So for today, we are going to do a simple crayon rubbing. It's very, very easy. All you're going to need is some crayons to work with. Darker the better for this, but light crayons will also work, but I always like using a black or maybe a dark purple. And then you're going to need a piece of paper and something to help you press down the crayon with. I'm going to use this marker. If you have a popsicle stick, that would be super awesome, but a marker works just fine. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is you're going to take your paper and you're going to fold it in half. It can be folded in half this way, or it can be folded in half this way. Doesn't matter. You just want one line of symmetry somewhere. So I like to match my edges up as best I can. Put my finger down to hold, slide, go down this way, and go on up this way. Then you're going to open that back up. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to draw half of a drawing on this side. Don't worry about this side yet. You will make a full picture, but we're only going to be drawing on this side. This method allows us to make an exactly symmetrical picture. So what we have on this side will reflect onto this side. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So simply, if I wanted to draw a cat, what I would do is I would draw half of the cat's head on this side. And nice and dark with your crayon is going to make this a lot easier for you. See how I only did half of the head? You don't want to finish it on this side. Then I'll give the cat one ear, then one eye. Half of its nose. So for the nose, you can see that I only did half of it. I pretended there was an imaginary line in the middle. Same thing for the mouth. I'm going to draw a line on the halfway point and curve it up. Last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to give my cat some whiskers. Now, what you're going to want to do is you are going to want to take your picture and you're going to want to fold it in half. Printer paper works awesome for this because it's thin enough that you'll be able to see your lines, but any other type of paper will work as well. You are just going to have to find it a little bit. It's going to be a little harder to find the lines, but you can still do it. So, what you're going to do is you are going to take your marker and you are going to rub on top of all of those lines. Now, if you had a popsicle stick, obviously you can use that as well, or any other tool that's going to help you rub those lines down. Because what you are doing is you are pushing that crayon that you just drew onto the second half of your paper. So you're gonna just rub all those lines. And you can always check to see how well you're doing. So you can notice that I didn't rub so much up here and that I could maybe rub a little bit more. It's never gonna be as dark as this side, so you're gonna, and I'll show you that in a minute, but you're gonna take your crayon and you're gonna trace over those lines. It's just meant to be a guide. So I'll fill in those spots that I missed. And we'll open it back up. Now, even though this line didn't pop out, I can still kind of see where it's supposed to go. So only be as perfectionist as you feel you have to be in order to see it. I feel I can see it well enough that I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to outline my other lines. So you just go right on top of what you drew. Bring that around. Over those whiskers. All right, and it's done.